Hello, coffee drinkers. I'm joining you with some La Croix. Does it ever happen to you that like the tank is just completely empty? You just like emotionally drained, physically drained perhaps, which I am today because I trained pretty hard, and just emotionally drained at the same time. Kind of a little bit overwhelmed, but a whole bunch of stuff, you know. Nothing life-threatening, nothing catastrophic, just lots of stuff, you know, life stuff. Does that happen to you? Happening to me today, big time. And my solution is always to get out of it with music. And I practiced this morning, maybe 15 or 20 minutes, sitting on the couch next to Chelsea with the metronome, like, you know, going through a little bit of my routine. But in the grand scheme of things, that felt quite inconsequential today. And I was just sitting here before I switched the camera on, thinking like, what am I gonna work on? Like, what is there to work on? What do I want to work on? And the answer kept coming back, nothing. There's nothing I wanna work on. So my initial response to that is, I'm totally okay with not working on something musically with the instrument. Totally okay with just stepping away from it and doing something else. But I've been doing so much of something else today. I wanted to try and keep up the consistency that I've had of playing every day and practicing a lot more lately. And then I open my email and I'm going through a few things, and I remember, you know, the great thing about being in this talking, pre-production, writing, organizing stage of this project with my friend Gabriel is that we send each other material to work on, and he had sent me some stuff that I'd listened to and thought was awesome but hadn't played yet. So I just listened to it, just the very beginning of it, to get the vibe. Something like this. I'm gonna put it in two different parts. He probably played it all at once, knowing him, he's a bad dude. But maybe I'll play it twice. And then the bass line is kind of offbeat, from what I remember. Two, three, four. Which is something I might not have thought of, and that's great. That's something immediately new for me. Melody to it and everything. He sent me two versions, one with and one without the melody. I think I listened to the one that just has the accompaniment with it. But this is how I get out of the kind of the shitty zone, you know, if I'm not feeling great and I do want to practice and I'm still motivated to practice. Like I said, I'm totally okay with stepping away from the instrument and being like, okay, today it just wasn't meant to be. But this consistency of practice thing has really been showing up in my chops, in my fluidity, in my overall comfort and confidence with the instrument and with kind of any music. I've been doing some of these practice sets, just grabbing the four string and playing along to pop songs and rock and roll and all kinds of things, and just playing sets of music. And that's felt really good. Like all of the work I'm doing, the technical stuff, the chord stuff, the melodic stuff, the writing, just the general consistency of getting with the instrument every day. There's a real noticeable difference for me, which at this point is kind of hard to get to. Like to really notice a difference or notice an improvement. Like there's a massive kind of plateau at some point. Like you get to a certain level, at least I felt that, there being a massive plateau. And feeling like, wow, okay, how do I take it to the next level? I think more importantly, how do I come up with goals that will force me to find new things in the music and force me to have to find new solutions and problem solve in a way that I haven't before? So that's been more my focus rather than, you know, okay, how do I take it to the next level? It really isn't about that at all. It's more about asking myself questions like, what do I want to do next? And recently I asked myself a question like, what do I want to do musically next? And this kind of idea with Gabriel came along, like completely unexpectedly. and I welcome that very much. And here I am, like, working on some of the material. And it's great, like, you know, I'm always searching for the right vehicle, you know, the right vehicle that allows me to express myself. When you look at a writing partnership of like Lennon and McCartney, for instance, they thrive together and they found ways to write songs and to communicate with people on a global scale. And then you look at maybe on more of the jazz side of things, maybe with a Lyle Mays, Pat Metheny kind of combination, where I think Lyle was kind of hugely responsible for writing the vehicle that worked best for Pat and created that sound of like of the Pat Metheny group from like the late 70s to kind of the mid 2000s was the last time I think they played on the way up. That's a long time, it's a long association, over 25 years of kind of Lyle being kind of not the puppet master, doesn't sound right, but like the maybe a little bit the mastermind, you know, the harmonic and melodic mastermind behind it. And as I work through some of this stuff with Gabriel, it's like interesting to be collaborating with someone on something in terms of the writing. Like, I don't do that when it comes to my solo projects or my co-led projects at all. You know, the co-led things, like the orchestral trio thing I did with Morgan and Alex, that was improvised. So we were collaborating, of course, but it was all improvised. There was no real writing process. So it's really fun to start kind of a new chapter of my life of collaborating with someone, and hopefully Gabriel isn't the last person I collaborate with, you know, not the only person I ever do this with. I think we kind of think similarly in certain areas, but are so vastly different in most other areas that will kind of, we'll be able to add things to complement each other, to each other's sound, to each other's writing, and hopefully make a really, really great recording out of it and create some great music. So those are kind of things that are on my mind when I sit down to practice. And at the end of the day, it's music driven. The motivation is music driven. I've talked about this in the past few days of like this overwhelming amount of crap out there of people who it's just technique driven and they never kind of get to the point. And of course, who knows what the point is? That's completely subjective, but most of the stuff I listen to, I don't connect with when it's like instrument driven or technique driven or chops driven. So I don't think I can reiterate enough like with my process and share with you guys how much it is driven by melody and by harmony and by music and by emotion and making emotional choices versus technical choices. And here we are, this is like the tip of the iceberg of this project, you know, three simple chords. And that is what's driving me today. Even on a day when I'm really not motivated to practice at all, that's the thing that gets me up and gets me into it, is something really beautiful, something very musical and very, very melodic. And it just felt like a good thing to jam to and to give myself a practice routine for the day. Even though it's only gonna be, you know, it's almost midnight here, it's only gonna be 10 or 15 minutes, but getting that consistency in, like I keep saying, is really the key. And I think that's what holds it together for me in the long run. Because if I had a lot of days like this where I don't feel like playing, I feel kind of emotionally, psychologically, physically drained, I think that might, you know, they say like in sports, like winning breeds winning, and losing, if you're losing all the time, like you can get in a funk and you can lose. But when you get on a winning streak, that really promotes more winning. I think that's kind of my mentality on some level. It's a little bit of a sports analogy for how I operate. I like to be on a winning streak, you know, I like to stay motivated, and that really helps me stay motivated. And give me some feedback on how you guys do it. Everyone is so different, like this is just the way I do it. What thoughts do you have on that? Leave me some comments below. That's always an interesting discussion. Maybe that can be like a Q&A thing. If you guys have something specific to ask about this particular situation, which I know we all fall into, you know, some more than others, and today I'm falling into it. I'm just so not motivated to be with the instrument. But there's always a way, you know, there's always a way to at least be satisfied, like super satisfied, even if you decide not to practice. You know what I mean? Like, explore all the options and make sure you've explored all the options and said, you know what, I've taken 5-6 different options here, I don't like any of them, I'm really not going to work on it today. But better that, in my mind, than just, I'm not going to work on it. I'm not going to even try. You know, I think that might be a bit of a cop out. I think it's good to step away and to know when to step away and take a break. But I also think it's good to explore all the options before you do that. And today I explored an option and it ended up being the thing that drew me in. And I guess I'm going to play out of today's vlog with a little bit of this material to give you an idea. Like, this is literally the first time I've put it in the looper while I've been shooting this video. And the first time I'm playing over it melodically. So we'll see what I come up with. And the preparation for this new project continues. I'm super excited about it. Totally emotionally drained. And I wish I could be like, whoa, right now on fireworks and screaming and shouting and jumping up and down. But deep down, I am very excited about it. And I'm trying to conserve what little energy I have left today to work on this material a little bit. So today's vlog is done. Hopefully tonight, the same thing that happened last night. Hopefully tonight, the vlog will upload properly. I hit publish and let it upload last night and then went to bed and woke up this morning and there'd been a connection drop or something and it didn't get uploaded when it should have done. So the vlog was all done, but the upload was sadly late. Hopefully that is not happening tonight and I will see you guys at the same time, coffee or La Croix, whatever it is you're indulging in, tomorrow. Thank you.